More jobs are coming to the metro. The high-tech firm Capgemini in Lee's Summit says it's adding 125 new jobs over the next several years.
Missouri Governor Jay Nixon was on hand for the announcement today, and KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney reports even some of Nixon's opponents are giving credit on the jobs front. Michael?
Yeah, that's right, Larry. If there is a jobs announcement in the state of Missouri, there is a good chance that Governor Jay Nixon could show up to help spread the news. Nixon has said repeatedly since he has taken office that creating jobs in Missouri is his main job as governor. So, how's he doing?
How you doing, sir?
I'm doing well.
What you working on?
It's a standard part of the Nixon routine. Meet some folks, whether it's in an office or a plant, roll into a room and make the announcement.
Thank you, Steve. It is certainly a pleasure to be here.
In this case, 125 new jobs at this Lee Summit branch of Capgemini. Now, the state says through October, Missouri has 4,000 more jobs than it did in 2010. And 2010 had 1,000 more jobs than the year before. And Nixon says Missouri workers help sell the state.
People in Missouri show up early, they stay late. They've got great values, they accept training, they're willing to compete, and that is a competitive differential.
I think that in the situation we're in, his economic development department does a pretty good job.
And Sirboy is a conservative Republican lawmaker from Lee Summit. Now, the state unemployment rate, once over 9%, is now dropping. It's under 9. But that's not to say that Nixon doesn't have problems. A special session to get a jobs bill this fall failed. And his administration is now under fire for a failed manufacturing plant project in Moberly.
The city had many, had quite frankly, had financial advisors, had counsel, had a lot of folks there working on the deal that I think as folks look at, there's good questions to ask everybody when deals don't go well.
Now, that failed manufacturing plant project in Moberly was the subject of 2 days of hearings down in Jefferson City that ended late this afternoon. It is a controversial project, and it may become an election year issue when Nixon stands for a second term next year. We're live with the skyline of downtown behind us. Back to you.
Micheal Mahoney, thank you very much for the latest. Meantime, the Kansas unemployment rate is at 6.7%. It's been steady since August.